escape around the storage shed, but the officers are hot on his tail. And less than 5 minutes later, they bring him in. This pursuit sped through two communities in only 20 minutes.
Got a rate of 110 miles an hour.
But thankfully, this 100 mile an hour roundup ended before it turned deadly. Thanks to a strategic effort by five separate police officers. Justice was served safely and swiftly.
Subject in custody.
El Campo, Texas. Dwayne is 18 years old, too young to buy booze, but he figures he's old enough to steal. But it's too late. Even if they hadn't already admitted their guilt, it doesn't take a genius to see they're smashed.
Are we going to set the car off or what?
Yeah, you probably should.
The officer is extremely patient, even when the suspects decide to turn on the charm. It was a nice try, but as the saying goes, flattery will get them nowhere. The officer heads back to his car to run the girls' IDs and to dodge their advances.
Oh my. They're lively.
We got you.
A second unit arrives, signaling the girls' inevitable arrest. The suspects can't understand it. They tried being honest. They've tried sweet-talking. There's only one thing they haven't tried yet.
Ladies, come back to the car.
Wearing little more than a chilly breeze, the girls streak away from the car. But instead of getting off the hook, they're actually racking up more charges. The officers search the girls' car. Of course, it won't be necessary to frisk the suspects themselves. Any way you look at it, they're busted. Police give the girls their clothes, some handcuffs, and a sobering dose of reality. But even evidence hesitate to follow. When a crook blazes his own path,
he's gotta cut the median.
Or gets onto a freeway by way of the off-ramp,
this is going to be pretty dangerous here.
The suspect will most likely be stopped not by police, but by disaster.